George in Denver, are you there?
Yeah.
Welcome, sir. Thank you.
How come God told us not to steal?
George, we're asking you, why are you an atheist?
Oh, I don't feel it viscerally, and I'm not convinced by the intellectual arguments.
Can you give an example of an intellectual argument that you found to be insufficiently persuasive?
Oh, like the Aquinas' arguments, like uncaused-cause, and I don't know.
Okay, well, he presented five, but what... Go ahead.
Sort of the intelligent design, I don't know, God's pretty... seems well-designed, too. There's three persons, so there's... why not a designer for that?
Oh, I see. Well, maybe we can start there. If God is so powerful, then who made God? Hmm, Trent Horn?
Well, that's assuming that everything that exists, if it's complex, requires some kind of designer to create it. But I would say that God actually isn't complex. What God is infinite being itself, the perfect act of existence, unrestricted, undivided, not limited in any way. Possess all that's perfect within this one single act of being. That is what God is. And God actually doesn't have any separate parts. Now, we can get into the reason of what the Trinity is. God has relations, but not little parts within him, like little pieces of baggage or things like that. So God just doesn't have a designer. But we look at the world itself, the world is not eternal. It's not self-sufficient like God. I think it kind of cries out for an explanation. But... so, George, let me just go back to you then, I guess. So you're saying, what term do you use? An atheist, non-theist? How do you identify yourself?
I told your the lady who took my call that I like non-theist.
Non-theist,
I think that's the same as atheist, but it's a little better because atheist, sometimes there's a positive and a negative style to the, or a connotation to that.
Right. Do you mean positive and negative?
Strong and weak.
Yes. The idea is that one could be an atheist if they say there is no God, and
right.
or someone who says, I don't see any evidence to believe God exists. It seems
right.
that you're...
I think non-theist is better than agnostic, but a lot of people sort of think agnostic is kind of a wishy-washy.
So you don't see a reason to believe in God because you haven't seen any good evidence.
Like I said, it just doesn't click in me viscerally,
and
people seem to still argue intellectually over it. And I've watched a lot of debates on YouTube, and I get frustrated because they're kind of the same, pretty much they cover the same ground, and nobody seems to really make a definitive.
So you haven't been touched.
Win.
You haven't been touched by those, and
what?
You haven't been touched. You mentioned the phrase viscerally in your guts, right?
Well, viscerally, people have an experience, a religious experience.
Sure,
I don't.
Okay, fair.
Well, George, I can actually sympathize with you. Is that I've had very, very, very few rare, quote unquote, religious experiences where I have felt the presence of God. In fact, the one I can remember the most vividly is when I was praying to God, saying, "Why can't I feel that you're there?" And hearing this voice coming back saying, you don't need to feel me, you know I'm here, and you need to show others I am. And I immediately wrote that off as not a voice from God, but just my own subconscious telling me this. So I sympathize, but I believe God exists not because I kind of get this burning feeling in the bosom, but because I think there are good reasons that point to him. So George, I have a question for you, though, I guess. What kind of evidence or kind of argument would show you that God exists?
I don't know. I don't know about an argument because I haven't heard the one that's going to, you know, close the deal for me yet.
But what,
and as far as some kind of miracle, I don't know.
I never said miracle. I just said what kind of
evidence. I don't know. I don't know.
Why hasn't
But going back to the very beginning of your show, I just want to know, how come God told us not to steal?
How come he told us not to steal?
Yeah.
Well, I would say that moral command represents an aspect of God's nature, that God is all-loving and he wills the good, and so he wills the good for all of us, and one good he wills is that we respect the God-given rights other people have. One of those rights is the right to have property, to have things we possess as our own, and we do not have the right as humans to take what others lawfully or rightfully own. So God told us not to steal, to reinforce the fact that we have the right to live and the right to own certain things, to reinforce the rights that he gave us.
Right. It's wrong. It's wrong to take something that doesn't belong to you that somebody else earned.
Yeah.
Now I noticed that when you answered it, you threw in first that it goes against the nature of God. So I know you've been asked that question before, so you know that if you just answer it by saying, well, it's wrong to just take something that doesn't belong to you, then you could find out that you don't need God to find out that something is wrong.
You're referring to what's called the Euthyphro dilemma. This is a dilemma that goes all the way back to Plato's dialogue, Euthyphro. It's basically, so you would put it this way, is stealing wrong because God says so, or does God say so because stealing is wrong? Is that kind of the dilemma you were thinking of?
I would just say stealing is wrong inherently in the act.
Okay.
It's the act that's wrong.
Oh, okay. Well, right. That's
not,
one.
Not a lot to disagree with there.
Well, hold on. You say stealing is wrong. That sounds like a factual statement. Like if I were to say the Earth is 93 million miles away from the sun, that's a fact that can be proven with, you know, a really, really long tape measurer or another scientific instrument. George, what instrument or tool do you use to prove that statement stealing is and that wrong is attached to it? Well, how do you prove that?
I'm just using common sense. I don't know if any philosopher has actually... I think Ayn Rand's kind of an amateur philosopher, but she's laid a foundation.
So, George, hold on a minute. So you're saying that stealing is wrong just because you... Stealing is something people should not do, and that's a fact because
because you took something that doesn't belong to you. You didn't earn it. But, you're an individual. You're an independent agent.
Yeah, George, actually, Trent's getting back to something very fundamental. No matter what the instance of stealing is, you're talking about fixing wrongness into the sentence.
Here's the problem, George, with your argument. It's circular. Stealing is wrong because you take something that doesn't belong to you.
Right.
But isn't taking something that doesn't belong to you, that's the definition of stealing. So you're just saying stealing is wrong because it's stealing.
Because you didn't earn it. You earn your own stuff.
Okay, then
don't take something that somebody else made for themselves or went out and worked for and take it for yourself.
George, here's the problem. You've pushed it back one step. Why is stealing wrong? And you're saying it's wrong because you have a right to what you earned. So my next question is, why do you have a right to what you earned?
Well, you told me that you gave me the answer. It's against our natural rights, our property rights.
Right, but
why do you know that? But
where do the rights come from?
I think in our nature.
Just what do you mean in our nature?
We're individuals, and we have to work to get the stuff we own. You pick the apple off the tree, and you maybe risked falling down off the tree. You get to eat the apple, not the guy who's standing there watching you, waiting for you, and then stealing it from you.
George, here's the thing.
You're
talking about rights as if they're real things that exist. Like, I have a right to own this.
No, I'm not saying that. A real thing, like one of Plato's, what do you call them?
A form.
Ideals or something.
No, not like an entity or an object, but
that exists objectively, which to me, it just seems like you're saying that certain actions are right or wrong. I don't know. Just because they are. They're wrong.
I liked your answer. The only thing I didn't need was that preface at the beginning that says, "Well, I have to throw in God here." And now I'll go ahead and give you the answer. It's property rights.
Well, no, George. To be fair, you asked Trent, why did God say stealing is wrong? So he referenced God in his reply.
Yes, and obviously God fashions the universe and the moral laws that we have in accordance with our natures. But just because something, you know, may not be in accord with our natures doesn't mean you can get from that to that there are certain universal rights and that we ought to treat one another way. I mean, eating a pig goes against the pig's nature to live. But it's not wrong to eat him. The question becomes, we may have certain natures, but why should we care about what our natures are? But if God created us and ordered our natures towards some certain good, and God is an ultimate source of value, if he is the good, then that starts to make sense of what we have.
Bacon. would like to have a sizzle sound effect. George, thanks for the input and the conversation. Edward Faser, in his book, The Last Superstition, I believe, takes up this dilemma and talks about divine command theory.
Yes.
Which would take us a little bit off of our main river, but thank you so much.